Installing new solar arrays for the space station, updating launch and landing dates for commercial crew, and NASA's new deputy administrator is confirmed. A few of the stories to tell you about this week at NASA. On June 16th, NASA's Shane Kimbrough and European Space Agency astronaut Thomas Pesquet ventured outside the International Space Station for a spacewalk to install the first of six new solar arrays that will help the existing arrays power the station. On June 20th, the pair is back outside to install the second array, with the other four being installed at a later date. NASA and SpaceX have adjusted target launch and return dates for upcoming commercial crew missions to and from the International Space Station. Our SpaceX Crew 3 mission is now targeted for launch no earlier than October 31st, while the Crew 2 astronauts currently on board the station are looking at a return to Earth in early to mid-November. The next crew rotation mission beyond that is targeted for no earlier than mid-April 2022. The U.S. Senate confirmed former NASA astronaut Pam MELROY to be NASA's next deputy administrator. President Biden nominated MELROY for the position in April. She is a veteran of three space flights, has more than 38 days in space, and is one of only two women to command a space shuttle. During a June 15th Senate hearing on the president's budget request for NASA, our Administrator Bill Nelson discussed how the budget will help America maintain its leadership role in space exploration. He also talked about the importance of the funding to STEM education initiatives, through which NASA can continue to recruit and maintain a diverse workforce, which has been key to the agency's success.
We are being very mindful to diversify. This, I believe, is directed for the entire executive branch of government, but I take it very, very seriously.
On June 15th, NASA launched Mission Equity, a comprehensive effort to review NASA programs, procurements, grants, practices, and policies, and assess potential barriers and challenges that may exist for historically underrepresented and underserved communities seeking access to them. The effort includes an agency request for public feedback. Find out more at nasa.gov/mission-equity. An agency LGBTQ+ Pride Month event on June 17th focused on the power of active allyship. It featured a panel discussion about what it means to be an ally, some of the barriers faced by the LGBTQ+ community, and what you as an active ally can do to help break down those barriers. To kick off the start of summer, the U.S. Postal Service issued a set of stamps highlighting NASA's Solar Dynamics Observatory, or SDO. The Sun Science stamps celebrate over a decade of sun watching for SDO. The mission helps researchers study and track regular solar activity, like solar flares and coronal mass ejections, which can impact technology and life on and near Earth. That's what's up this week at NASA. For more on these and other stories, follow us on the web at nasa.gov/twan.